Good morning, everyone. Thank you for the great introduction. So my name is Lucija, and today I'll be presenting a portion or a part of my PhD project, which has the goal to investigate sentiments towards migration in Austrian newspapers, and my supervisor is Georg Vogler. And today, basically, I'm going to talk about the first two parts, so the selection of newspapers and the creation of a topic-specific corpus. Since I'm mainly interested in sentiments towards migration, I also want to create a smaller migration-specific corpus. So regarding the selection of newspapers, I had some preliminary criteria. The first one was that all the newspapers that I want to look at are in German and published in modern-day Austria, so in cities like Vienna or Graz or Salzburg. The time frame that I was looking at, so that I'm still looking at, is from the 18th to the 20th century, so until 1938. And this comprises two already available, publicly available corpora, so the Digitarium, which is made available by the Austrian Academy of Sciences, and the Anno Corpus, which is by the Austrian National Library. In this talk, I'm going to be mostly focusing on my experiments that I did on Digitarium, so more specifically on the 328 issues of Wiener Zeitung, which is actually the only newspapers that we the only daily newspaper in German that we have available from the 18th century. And this is an official government publication, which was closely associated with the Habsburg monarchy, which can also give us some insights into which topics we might find in this collection. So regarding this experiment, I had some questions. So how can we efficiently create a workflow for the creation of a representative topic-specific corpus, so of a migration-specific corpus? Which terms can we find that are connected to migration and different migrant groups? And how do they change and develop over time, so through the 18th until the 20th century? And what I was suspecting is that dynamic topic modeling as a technique can aid the creation of specialized corpora. And also, on the other hand, that in the 18th century, so that in the Digitarium corpus, I might not find so much topics on migration due to a potential censorship in the media, but also because of the style or the type of the periodical that Wiener Zeitung was. It was mostly public announcements, talks about war, and so on, but more on that later. So looking into different methods that were previously used for the creation of topic-specific corpora, keyword search was one of them, which was found to be problematic because of different OCR errors, which led to loss of information. And topic modeling was also used, which is the automatic detection of hidden themes in text, mostly through LDA. However, this was done through static topic modeling, so without a temporal aspect. But I wanted to try dynamic topic modeling, which are basically techniques used for analyzing the evolution of topics over time. And they're specifically suitable for corpora that have a temporal aspect, such as newspapers, and were previously used in modern newspapers when it comes to migration, so especially regarding the refugee crisis that happened in around 2015. So this was my experimental setup, let's say. I first started by scraping all the TIs, so all the XMLs from the Digitarium, then extracted the plain text. After that, even though all of these, so the Digitarium is created automatically and post-corrected, I also had to do some post-correction of some of the issues. And then, because I wanted to try different methods of topic modeling, both static and dynamic, I had to do pre-processing for the static one, for the LDA and NMF, and I had to do some pre-processing for LDA-SEC, which is the dynamic topic model extended from LDA. For the bird topic that I used, no pre-processing was necessary because it is a transformer model. When it comes to the static topic modeling, so the LDA and the NMF that I ran on these 300 issues, so I did some pre-processing, as I said, removed stop words, punctuation, removed non-alphabetic characters, Roman numerals, normalized some of the text because some was probably not going to be well recognized by the models because of some differences in the orthography. And then I used the LDA and the NMF models from GenSim. And here the most important thing is, of course, how many topics you choose. In the end, I ended up with 5 topics because that's how I got the best evaluation results. However, this method takes no account of the context or the word order. So with the evaluation, the LDA perplexity results were not so good. The NMF were a little bit better, and I think that's reflected in the topics that I have presented here. So with the LDA, I showed only the ones that actually I thought that were interesting and made sense. The first one with the LDA is mostly about like court life and news. And so on. So we have words like house and court and emperor and stuff like that. And the one with the NMF is specifically dealing with house market sales, because at the end of the 18th century there was a lot of houses sold in the newspapers, through the newspapers. We have words such as solicitor, to sell, and so on. Then with the other method that I use, so the LDA sec, I'm reporting this because I also hope to get some feedback on this one, because my experiences were that on one hand it requires pre-processing, which takes a lot of time and human effort, but it also has a especially long computational time, which also found other records of that online. It doesn't account for the context. I put the settings that I used, so I also used 5 topics. I used only 5 iterations because it was really taking a long time to compute. And I used 2 time slices. It depends. So if you use more time slices, so I could use 1 time slice per year, but that would even increase the computational time. So I decided to split it in half, so the first part of the century and the second part of the century, because I also saw with previous analysis that there was a change in the style and the topics in the newspapers when it comes to the first half and the second half of the century. I think a good endpoint from this is that we can easily export the documents where certain topics are present. However, in the graphs, we see the first and the second time slice, and there are not that many differences in the frequency of some of the words. There's a little bit difference in like topics, the topic in the word like king and city and so on. And in the second one in sir and general and so on. For me, the conclusion from using this method was that it was not entirely satisfactory, I would say. But then I tried dynamic topic modeling with bird topic. And I was initially a bit concerned because it is 18th century German, and bird topic does offer a multilingual model. Thought it should be fine because it's embeddings and topic modeling. So basically it works by creating dense clusters, making interpretable topics. And as we see on the right side, I have the first 7 topics. So the first one is dealing with ships and maritime travel, the second one with the king, the court, and so on. Then we have one dealing with Russia and relations with Russia, which were prominent in the 18th century. Then we have some dealing with army, and so these are the most the 6 most frequent topics in this analyzed period. So with bird topic, we're able to represent all the topics detected in the corpus, and we have a simple overview of all the documents in which each topic is present, and we can also just put in a document and see whether there is a certain topic or not in that specific document. But I think these are the most interesting graphs, at least for me. So in the first one, we see the 10 most frequent topics and how they kind of develop over time. The first most frequent one was dealing with ships, and we see kind of with the orange color, it's a bit noisy because there are so many topics, but the first one is kind of present during the whole century. Then, for example, the one dealing the number 9 one, the one dealing with like commodity sales spikes at the end, because that's when they started giving out ads for selling houses and things in the newspapers. Then we have, for example, a spike for army and infantry in the 80s, and so on. Then in the second graph, I put the topics that I found interesting as well. So for example, death and illness spiked during the 40s and the 60s. Then we have topics about houses also, like house sales, topics about the army in the 60s and the 40s, topics about deaths in the 80s and 90s, and about the Jewish community and religion, which were kind of appearing. It was not a very frequent topic, so it's the pink color is not very prominent, but we see that there is a part in the 80s and 90s. So to conclude, it was confirmed that there is not many, or that at least I didn't detect many migration topics in the 18th century, but rather news on court life, wars, and the market. But I do believe that bird topic and dynamic topic modeling are a suitable and easy way to help the process of a topic-specific corpus creation. And I think one of my next steps is to do more evaluation on this before I apply it to the other newspapers that I have specifically from the ADHO corpus. So thank you all for listening.